all are at the platform of the wire where we are here to win the dreams. So I welcome to all of you in this ArtistNet journey. And before the starting, as we always goes for the positive quotes, some superpower, super energy, some positive quotes. So which says that if you want something you never had, you have to do something which you have never done. Of course, if you want something better, then we have to do this best. Right? Then only we will get the at least better. So of course, you have to do something different for that. And now let's start. So what will be the agenda? What will be the agenda of our today's session? We have already started the average topic, correct? And we have seen the average. What is the average? How to find out the average? Then we have solved three types of questions on the average too. And in today's session, we will continue that topic. We will go for the recap with recap that what is the average, how to find the average, and then we will go for the type number 4, type number 5, and type number 6. That means we will see the three types of the questions of the average. We will see what is the basic required to that, what are the questions of that. Then we will solve some questions. At the end, there will be practice questions for you on every type. Okay. So this is how we will complete our today's session. So let's go for the session. What is the average? So what is the average? Average is nothing but the mean. That means whenever there are number of observation, number of things, then whatever the exact mean of that, what should be mean of that, all the observations. Then how we find out that? Average is equals to the sum of all the observations, that is addition of all those observations divided by number of observations. That means if suppose there are 5 subjects, then whatever the marks we have gained in the 5 subjects, we will add them all 5 and we will divide their all addition divided by 5 because we are calculating for the 5 subjects. And whatever will be the answer, that will be the average of your marks. This is how we find out the average. Right? We have seen this. So before going for the type number 4, we will go as before that. Let's solve one question just for example practice. Suppose one question. What question should I give actually? Suppose there is a class where 20 students have got the 20 students, average of 20 students. Okay, I'm explaining. Average of 20 students is 50. And average of remaining 15 students, suppose, okay? Average of 15 students is, what can we take? Let's take, suppose, 60. So, what is the average of class? What is average of whole class? What should be the answer? Let's solve this question first, then we will go for the next type. So, answer me in the chat section by solving this. As there is a class, there are total 20 plus 15, that are the total 35 students. But in between that, in those 20 students, average is a 50. And in the 15 students, average is a 60. So what will be the average of whole class? As we're solving this, how will we find that average is equals to, total average is equals to, this is a total average, right? Total average is equals to, first let's take the sum of these 20 students. So what will be the sum of these 20 students? Because I want a sum here, right? And in that 35 students, they are given for first 20 and then 15 students. So what will be the sum for 20 students? It will become that average is a 50 and total number of students is a 20. So sum will be 50 into 20. Plus for these 15 students, sum will be 16 into 15 divided by total number of students are these 20 plus 15. This is how we will solve. So what will be the answer? These 5 twos are 10. That means it will become 1000 plus 16 twos, it will be 900, right? Divided by 35. So it will become 1900 divided by 35. So if I take 5 sevens are and 5 threes are 15. 5 8s are, it is around 380 by 7. That means it is around 7 5s are 30. And again 3s remain, that means 7 4s are 20. So what are you answering? Yeah, 54 point something. Yes, it will get 54 point something. 7 4s are 28, then 2s remain, 7 2s are, and 7 8s are something, right? Around 54.28 will be the answer. Instead of this, if I say the total average, okay? Suppose I change the question here. I'm taking just for the practice. Let's see, then we will go for the next time. But before that, one practice is also important. Now let tell me. Now tell me that suppose total average, okay? Total average of the class is equals to suppose 32, okay? Now the average of 18 student is suppose 28, and the average of 12 students kya aayega? Find out what will be the average of 12 students. There are suppose total overall class. In that class, the average will be 32. If the 18 students average the 28, then what will be the remaining 12 students average? Find out this. So let's see. What will we do here? As we know that the average is the 32, right? So average is equals to 32. And what is sum divided by total number of students? How many total number of students here? This 18 plus this 12, right? Now what is the sum of these 18 students? 18 into 28 plus this 12 into, suppose this is a P, because I don't know what is the exact average. Now let's solve this 18 plus 12, it will become 30. So 32 into 30, which is equals to this 18 8s are 144, right? Yeah, 18 8s are 144. So carry I have 14, 18 2s are 36 plus 14, it will become 50. 504 plus 12 P. So this 504, it will become 960, sorry, 940 or 60, yeah, 960, sorry. Minus 504 is equals to 12P. So 960 minus 404, it will become 456 divided by 12. So what will be the answer here? 12 threes are 36. How are you getting this? 38? It won't be exact 38. It will become around, yeah, sorry, 12 8s are 96, sorry. So answer would be 38. Is there anyone who have doubt? Can we go for the next type of questions? Yes, 38. Okay, clear? Very good. Now just orally give me one answer, but please answer me orally, okay? I will write down question here first. Suppose there is a series . What will be the average of this? ?27 will be the average. Very good. Yes, very good. 27 will be the answer because this is in the middle term, right? Now suppose there is a consecutive. There are five consecutive numbers. There are five consecutive numbers which average is 52, then what will be the smallest number? There are five consecutive numbers. Okay, so what I said, there are five consecutive numbers which average is a 52. So what will be the smallest one? There are five consecutive numbers. I'm repeating the question. Consecutive numbers whose average is a 52. So which will be the smallest number? Someone are saying 48. As I said, 52 is the average and those are the consecutive number. Not consecutive, even, odd or multiple of anything. Those are the normal consecutive natural numbers. So what should be the answer? 50 should be the answer. Because as those are the consecutive, so 52 will be the middle term and there are total 5 numbers. That means 2 aage do peeche aa jayenge, right? Then here will be 51, 50 and here will be 53 and 54. As they are asking you the smallest number, so answer will be 50. If they ask you the largest number, it will become 54. Difference between the smallest and largest, it will become 4. Question might be any type. Okay, understood now? Very good. Now let's go for the next questions. As the type of the questions which we are going to see in today's session now, okay? As the type number 4, type number 5 and type number 6 we are going to see the three types. In the type number 4, we will see the calculation error based question. That means what happens, sometimes we write down all those numbers for the addition. Sometimes it may happen that by mistaken we can write wrong number. Instead of 52, we can write 25. This type of error happens, and yes, we will see those type of question when there is an error based question. Then type number 5, where any new member is added in the group. Sometimes in the group there is something in the group and one new member gets added in that group. And type number 6, where the number member or person is added or removed, and it is a replace. Most important thing, and is the number is a replace, that member is replaced by another member. Then what will be the type of questions will be there. So let's go for the type number 4 first. It is a calculation error based question. Now, when randomly 5 numbers are given, the third one is the mean. If those numbers are the consecutive, okay? What I said, consecutive. मतलब हर एक number के बीच का difference same होना चाहिए. If the number, those numbers are the consecutive, then it will be the middle term. If those are not consecutive, then it's not the average. Okay? Yeah. So now this is the type number 4 calculation error based question. So we will directly go for the question here. So I will explain you. What is the question they are saying? That the average of 100 observations was calculated as 35. 100 observations are there and average is calculated as 35. Now if it was found later that one of the observations was misread as 83 instead of 53. That means what happened? One student have observed 100 numbers. He has calculated as the average of the 35. But after that he found that there was a number 53. But instead of taking 53, he write down the 83 and then he makes the calculation. That means suppose there is something calculation error, then they are asking that what is the correct average. Because if he is taking a wrong number, that means suppose that average is wrong. So what will be the correct average they are asking you here? Very good. Some students have already answered. That's really great. Very good, perfect. So what will we do here for this? Let's do something. Suppose let's take this is a wrong and right, okay? Because ek to wrong hai, ek right. Right? So number of observations, those are the 100. Those are correct. Number of observations are 100 and 100. This is the correct thing, right? So if I said what is the average? Average, wrong average is a 35, right? So that sum will become 3500. Up to this is okay. Some students are answering here. Okay, very good. That's really great thing. So let's see, as by the wrong number, okay, by the wrong calculation, the number of observations were 100. You find out the average of 35. So sum will be 3500. Right? Here again, for the right observation is 100, but that average will be different. Right? So but for this wrong calculation, what is the number he have taken? He taken the 83 instead of 53. That means that wrong number was the 83. Right? The wrong number. That wrong number he written as 83. But what is that actual number? It is a 53. That actual number. That is the actual number or right number is a 53. That means by how much it is reducing? It is reducing by the 30. Are you getting this point? Actual wrong means me kya liya hai? Wrong means me consider kya that number is 83. But in reality that number is a 53. That means we have taken this 30 more. So for the actual answer, I will reduce that 30. If this 30 is reduced, that means of course this sum will also get reduced by the 30. That means this sum will reduce by the 30 minus 30, which will become 3470. Are you okay with this? Anyone have doubt, then you can ask, okay? But this is a 3470. That means that sum is 3470 and number of observation is 100. So what will be the average? Average is equals to number of, that is the sum divided by the average. So it will become, this average will become 3470 divided by 100, which is equals to 34.7. This is the conventional method we have solved actually. But while 2.3 from 35, I have to explain that thing. But before that, this method is everyone is clear with this? Please tell me, everyone is clear? Anyone have doubt in this method? I have written here wrong one, right one. So from the right and wrong, what is the difference? This difference is the 30. Okay, I'm explaining this once again. Then I will tell you directly how to solve this question. Okay, this is the conventional method. In the conventional method, what am I writing here? This is the wrong one and this is the right one because there are two calculations. One calculation he has done, which is the wrong, but they are asking me for the right one. So for the wrong one, number of observations is 100. For the right one, observations will remain the same. Right, and for the right wrong one, average he has calculated as the 35. So the addition will become 3500. Sum will become, because sum is equals to average into number of observation by the formula of the average. Right. So I got the, so he, whatever who have, if that person had done the wrong calculation, he got the sum as a 3500. Up to this is okay. But as after that he realized that, he write down the number 83 instead of the 53. That means actual number 53 tha. In actual, in the right condition, that number is a 53. But by mistake, he has wrote it as 83. That means this is the 83 is a wrong. But by this 83 and 53, by how much it is the? It is a minus 30, right? Because from the right and wrong and right, what is the difference between wrong and right? It is a minus 30. That means to make the right, you have to minus 30. You have to subtract those 30. So you will subtract that 30 from this sum also, from this addition also. So if you subtract this 30, you will get here 3470. So the actual addition will be 3470. But by the mistake, he has made this addition as a 3500. So by this actual addition divided by the number of observations, you will get the average. Okay. What is actually wrong number? I mean in a question. 83 is a wrong number and 53 is a correct number. What are they saying? He was misread as 83. Misread as 83 means 83 is a wrong number. Instead of 53, instead of matlab ke actual mein wo 53 hai, but in this case he write down as the 83 by mistake. Okay, clear now? This method is okay. Now I will explain how to directly write down, how to directly solve the question. Please tell me, anyone have doubt? And as I have explained it once again, so it is clear. Okay, yeah. Now, after this, we will let's see that how to directly write down. Instead of solving this all, what will we do? As you know, what is the original and wrong one? This wrong number is 83, right? And this actual right number is 53. That means how much it is the difference? 30. But this difference is 30 out of what? This total average, right? This 30 will affect with what? Ye 30 jo extra ka add kiya hai, wo kispe affect karega? It will affect this total average. So you just have to subtract as a, sorry, from this average, right? That means it will get subtracted. Because why? Because this wrong number is a more and your actual number is a less. That means your average should be the less. Are you getting my point? Actual mein aapka usme jo number hai that 83. But in reality, that right number is a 53. That means it is subtracted by the 30, minus 30. That means your average will also get minus 30. But out of this 30 will be out of this all 100 observations. That means you will do like this 35 minus 30 by 100. So this 30 by 100, it will become, as you know, 1010 is cancelled. 35 minus 0.3, which is equals to 34.7. So you can find out directly like this. Okay, I'm explaining this once again. Please concentrate here. What was I saying? Instead of doing this all, as you know, in actual that number is a 53, but by mistaken he has taken the 83. That means your actual number is less than 30. It is a less, right? Your actual number is a less. So your average should be the less. So what will you do? This average minus. Why minus? Because my average should be the less. My less by what? By this 30 total addition. But this 30 within what? This all those 100 numbers. 30 out of the 100 numbers. So 30 out of this 100. Ma'am, of it is more than, it should be added, right? Yeah, if it was a more than, then we should add it. But as this is a less number, right? He has taken this wrong, highest number, but in actual that number was a less. So what I did, just 83 minus 53, 30. Out of what? Out of 100 number of observation, 30 by 100 is a 0.3. Let's subtract this 35 minus 0.3, it is a 0.3. 34.7. So instead of solving this all, you can directly write down this. So now let's go for the next question. If you understood this, then at least I will get to know that you have understood or not. This question you are going to solve. Okay, what I wanted to say, that is 35 is the average, right? The wrong average is a 35, right? But as you know that the wrong number and the right marks, okay, wrong and right. And what is the wrong and what is the right? He has written the 65 instead of the 30. Wrong is a 65, but right is a 35. And that means my right one is a less, right? This right one is a less. So I will subtract 35 minus less by what? 30. So 30. Out of how many observations are there? Total observations are 30 observations, right? Total, total children, right? Total children of the class is equals to 35, so it will become 35. So this 30 by 35, it will become 5, 6 R and 5, 7 R. So 35 minus 6 by 7. What will be the answer for 6 by 7? You see this, let's 30 by 7, 6 by 7, it will become 35 minus, that will become 7, 0.7, 8s are 56, right? 7, 8s are 56 and again 4, that is 7, 5, 5, 5 around. So if I do the 0.855 around, I will get as the answer 34.14 and I will, this 5, 5, 5 will become 86. So my answer would be 34.14. Still some students have given the wrong answer. Exactly what are you doing? You are doing that 1195 by 35. Okay. You are doing 35 into 35. 1225 minus 30. It will become 1195. Yeah, right. So you can do like that way also. You are not understanding? Okay. I am explaining this once again. Let's concentrate here. Please concentrate here. Okay. As there are total children are the total class. So the total class of 35 children. Right. 35 children. And the total class average is a 35. Okay. But the average marks of the class, that is the 35 marks to the 35 children. But at the end, what are they saying? The marks of one of the students who got 35 was incorrectly entered as a 65. Matlab usme se ek students ko 35 bhi marks mile the. But by mistaken, that teacher took that marks as a 65. That means, of course, this average will get different, right? He got the average as a 35. He find out something, he got the average as a 35. But at the time, he find out that the average of the marks of one student, he taken wrong as the 65. He entered as the 65. But in the right one, these marks are actual 35. That means he has taken this 30 marks more. Right? This 30 marks more. That means, of course, in the reality, that 30 marks are less. That means my average is also less. Are you getting this? As you know that in reality, these are the wrong marks and these are the right marks. So in reality, in the right way, that students have got the less marks. So that average will also get less. Less means what? Let's subtract this. 35 minus. Less by what? By this 30 marks, because there is a difference of 30 marks, but 30 out of what? This 30 will affect to that 30 will marks will get subtracted from all the 35 children's addition. Right? So this will divide by 35. So last time, instead of that, you can do like this also cross multiplication if you know that. 35 into 35. As you know, 35 square, which is easy, so it will become 1225. minus this 30 divided by 35. So it will becomes 1225 means around 1190, right? 1190 divided by 35. So if you solve this 1190 by 35, 5 7s are, 5 2s are, 5 3s are, and 5 8 are. 238 by 7. Now let's solve it. 7 3s are 21. And 7 4 are, wait, is there any mistake? It should not be 34 exact. Is there any mistake or anything? Okay, it was a 1195, right? Yes, it was a 1195. So it should be the 9. So this should be the 9. Yes, so 7 4s are 28, remainder is the 1. 7 1s are 1 and 7 4s are 38. So answer would be 34.14. 6 by 7 is a more faster. Yes, 6 by 7 is a more faster. But for that, okay, please show by the 6 by 7. Okay. For this 30 by 35, you can write down this as a 5 6 are and 5 7 are. So let's, what will be the 6 by 7? It will become 7 0 the 7, 7 8 are, right? 7 8 are 56 and this 4 again, 7 5 are, right? And again 7 5 5 5. That means it is around 0.86. I will subtract this from the 35, 35 minus 0.86, it will become 34.14. And actually, this will help you by the options also. As you know, 35 minus point something, that means that number definitely will be greater than 34. So option is, there is only one option. So answer will be 34.14. Okay, it will 857, no, okay, 857. I don't think so, it will be 857. Because 7 5s are 35 again. Okay. Sorry. It is around 857. That is not the issue. So by the around, it will be around equals to the 34.14. Okay. Now everyone is okay with this. Is there anyone have problem? Yes, we have to decide whether add or subtract from the right answer. If a right one is a greater, then let them add. If a right one is a less, then subtract. Understood? Okay, ma'am. In case they have taken more than two students mark wrong, then do we separately? Yeah, next question is that one. There are two marks actually. In the next question, there are two marks. Okay, so let's see the next question now. And yeah, this is the question where the two students' marks are given. Now, what will we do? First, let's concentrate here. The average marks of 14 students was calculated as 71, but it was later found that marks of one student had been wrongly entered as 42 instead of 56 and of another student as 74 instead of 32. Now, what will be the correct average? Okay, so let's write down your wrong and right. Okay, so first of all, first student, he has taken 42 instead of 56. That means original was for 56, but by mistake he has taken the 42. Right? And for the next student, he has taken 74 instead of 32. 74 instead of 32. Right? Now this is the right, this is the wrong, this is the right. So what is the here? We are adding here plus 14, right? It is a plus 14. And this will be minus. Minus what? 4 minus 2 and is 42. Plus 14 minus 2. Okay. So if I did 14 minus 42, what will be the answer? It will become minus 28. Right. So what I have to do here? 71 minus 28 divided by number of students were 40. 14 ones are, 14 twos are, 71 minus 2, answer will become 69. Many students have already answered. Very good. Answer would be 69. Now understood what I have done for the two or more students. Oh, sorry, more than one students. Okay, I'm repeating this one, sir. As I know, what I am doing for every time, this was the wrong, this is the right. They are saying that he took the 42 instead of 56. That means right one is a 56, wrong one is a 40. For the another students, what he do? he takes the 32 of 74 instead of the 32. That means wrong one is a 74, right one is a 32. Now I have to add them all, right? So first mein kitna difference aaya? In the first one, it is a plus 14. Right? Because for to get the right one, I have to add 14 here. Right? To make this wrong to the right, I have to add 14. And I have to make this wrong to the right, I have to subtract 42. So in averaging totally, plus 14 minus 42, that means to make the right one, I have to subtract to 28. Because plus 14 minus 42, it will become minus 28. Right? So what will I do? This 28 is a minus. That means in actual, 28 my marks should be reduced. So I will subtract this 28 from the 71. But this 28 are out of 14 students. So 14 to the 28, that means 71 minus 2 will be 69. Now understood? So after that, there are the practice questions for you. Let's take the screenshot. And do if we solve this way, how will we get correct as answer in case both 72 and 69? As first I am doing for this, then next I am doing. So whatever the last. If you do right first this and then this, then also you will get the answer as a 69. What are they at the last of completing the question? At the end, you are getting 69. That means answer is a 69. The 72 is not the exact answer. Because after that one process was remained. That's why I have taken here together so that you won't get confused or you can't forget anyone. You will directly take both together. Okay? So this screenshot is done now. Now let's go for the next type. Before that, are you sure everyone is clear with this step? Everyone is saying yes, that means yes. I hope so. You have cleared now. So let's go for the next question now. As the type number 5, new members added in the group. Okay, when sometimes what happens, the new member gets added in the group. So this formula I will show you after. First, let's solve this question by the conventional or by your way. Let's try this question if you know any method. Yes, many students have answered. As what will be the sum? As the mean is a 9, mean of a 9 observation is a 16, right? That means average is equals to 16. Number of observation is equals to 9. So what will be the sum? Sum will be 16 into 9, which is equals to 144. Right? For the 9 terms, it is okay. Now they are saying that if the new member, okay, new one more observation is included, the mean becomes 70. If one more observation included, then number of observation becomes 10. Right? And then average is equals to 70. Then what will be the sum? Then sum will become 17 into 10, which is equals to 170, right? After adding this. So if after adding sum becomes 170, before adding that sum was a 144, so that new observation will definitely 170 minus 144, which is equals to 26. Getting this point? Still one student is saying option number A, 9. Two students have answered this. Why 9? As if you observe this, what am I saying here? Please concentrate. I am repeating this and then I will repeat by the short trick also. Okay? Or by the formula. That is not the short trick. That is also one of the formula actually. Okay. So as you know that there are total 9 observations. Sorry, 9 observations. Okay. Number of observations. There are total suppose 9 observations and the average of all those 9 is a 16. Now they say that one more observation is added in that. Then that average becomes 17. Ab jab ye one more observation add ho jata hai, then what is happening? That average is becoming the 17. So what will be the new observation which is added? So what will be that observation? Okay. So initially when the observation was average was 16 and number of average observation was 9, then the sum of those observations will be 144. This is okay. Now what happens? In that 144, something is added. Right? Or else, how can we write down here? How
How did you decide to make the correct?
Okay. So as you know that if I take the 144, in that 144 sum, number of 10th observation is added. Now the number of observation becomes the 10 and average is the 70. I am writing this. This is what I have written. You can write down in the formula. Now the average is equals to sum of what number of observation. Initially that sum is equals to sum divided by number of observation were 9 and average were 16. Then I got the sum as a 144. Right? Now for the next sum, what are they saying? Now average becomes 70 when one more observation is added. That means now the number of observations will become 10 and that 144 plus that observation is added. So here what will be the value of this x? It will becomes 170 minus 144, which is equals to 26. So answer would be 26. Getting this, anyone have still problem? We just need 26 more to make it correct. Yeah, we need 26 more to make it correct to make this average as a 70. Yes, okay. Now this is the formula when new number, new observation is added. Okay, this is the trick formula you can say, or this is the formula. Now how will we apply this formula or how to write, I will show you here. Okay, so as you know that whenever you want a new observation, whenever new observation is added, then that new observation is always equals to the whatever the new average, or what can I say, the number of old average, number of old observations, sorry, number of old observation into increase in average plus new average. What am I saying? जब भी हमारा कोई भी new observation add हो जाता है, whenever the new observation added, then the new observations value will always be equals to the number of old observations into increase in the average, plus that multiplication plus the new average. This is the formula actually. Okay, to solve this type of question in the quick way, if you remember this formula, then you can solve these questions within some seconds. Now let's try the same question by this formula. As you know that number of old observation was 9, increase in average, average initial average was 16, new average is a 17, that means average is increased by the 1, so 9 into 1 plus new average. What is the new average? 17. 17 plus 9 will become 26. So this is the answer. Getting this point? This is the formula. Can we say new sum minus old sum to get a new value observation? New sum minus old sum. Yeah, new sum minus old sum. You can say like that also. New sum minus old sum is equals to whatever the new observation was added. But here also new observation of added is equals to the number of old observations, whatever those are, into the increase in the average plus new average. Increase will be the new average or the difference. Increase in average means the difference between the new average and old average. Agar old means 16 tha, now it becomes 17. That means it is increased by 1. Increase in old average plus new average. Sum is equals to average into observation. Yes. Sum is equals to, yeah, that was the formula itself. So with this formula, everyone is okay. Now let's solve the one more question actually, so that I think so you will get more clear. This is the question number 2. Okay. So as you know that there are total number of old observations. There are total 11 players initially into average is increasing by 2 years plus now as initially the average was 20. If the average is increasing by the 2, that means new average will become 22. Getting this point? Initially that was a 22. Now it is increased by the 2. That means it will become 20. 2. So what will be the answer? 11 to the 22 plus 22, it will become 44. That means the age of the coach will be 44. Understood this to everyone? I'm ending this poll now. Yes, you can do like that also. 264 minus 20. If there is a decrease in average, question number 4 is on the decrease. No, I think so. That is not in the decrease. But if it is a decrease, it will become minus. So whatever this number, here it's a plus. So I will subtract from this number. It should be the minus. If that average is decreasing, suppose it was a decrease by the 2, then it will become 11 into minus 22. But as in this question, it's not possible because 11 into minus 2, that means minus 22. And this is decreasing by that means that new average will become 20 minus 2, which is equals to 18. So 18 plus 18 minus whatever it becomes, as they, of course, they made the question, at least that value won't be negative if they are asking for the age. Okay. Now let's solve the next question. As the question number 3 is again here. Okay. So as what are they saying? A cricket has a certain average of runs for his 8 innings. I don't know what is the average. What is the old average? But they are saying that certain average for his 8 innings. That means number of old observation is 8. Right? Then what are they saying? In the ninth inning, he scores 100 runs. That means in the new one, 100. That new observation, 100 is adding into. But what are they saying? That then after the 9 runs, thereby increases his average by the 9. Increase in average is a 9. So they are asking you that what is the new average, right? So his new average will be what? Initially, old, there were 8 innings. That but after scoring the 100 runs, the average increased by the 9. Okay, so what will the answer? 100 minus equals to 9, it is 72 plus question mark. So this question mark will becomes 100 minus 72, which is equals to 28. Some students are saying 24. 24 is not the answer. Answer is 28. So, have you understood this? Whatever I have written on the board, anyone have doubt, then please ask. No one is asking anything. That means everyone is okay with this. Can we go for the next question? Understood? Very good. Perfect. So, this was the formula. Simple. You just have to put the value in this. Okay? You want this question without this formula? Okay, now please concentrate here. If you want this question without, actually I think so there are too many. Okay, without the formula, how will we solve this question? This is a quite difficult. Please concentrate here. Okay, now a cricketer has a certain average of runs for 8 innings. In his 9th inning, he scored 100 runs, thereby increase his average by the 9 runs. Okay, so let's consider initial average was 8. Initial average was the x. And number of innings is a number of innings means number of observations, right? Which are the 8. So what will be the sum of all runs? Sum of all runs up to this 8 match. That sum will be average into number of innings, which is equals to 8x. Now it is okay. If anyone have doubt, then please ask. If they had given the new average, this formula not work. It will be work because new average is in the last one. Okay, I will explain that after this. Please first concentrate here itself. Okay, wait, I will explain that one also. So as I said, initially, I'm just solving this by the conventional method. Please concentrate here. Initial average was suppose x. And the total number of innings was the 8. So that sum of all the runs is the 8x. Now the 100 runs is added, right? Initially, uske 8x the, but now in that 8x, 100 runs are added. right? But now, as you know, this is a sum. But the number of innings is also increased, right? Initially, उसने 8 innings खेले थे. And now, if we make the 100 runs in the next inning, that means number of innings becomes 9. Number of observations is also increased. And now, his average is increased by the 9. What are they saying that? His average increased by the 9. That means if initially his average was the 8, now his average will become x plus 9. Getting this point?
Anyone have doubt, then please ask whatever I am saying. 28, what are you saying? As we have already solved this, dear, so we know answer is a 20.
Okay? So, as initial average was the x, so number of innings was the 8 at that time. So, I find out that the sum of up to this 8 innings, it was the 8x. Now, in that 8x, these 100 runs are added. So, this is the sum. Right? But as sum divided by number of observation, that means number of innings. Now that innings is also increased. Initially there was 8 innings, now 9 innings are there, which is equals to average. Average is also increased by the 9. That means initially average was the x, now average is the x plus 9. Now let's solve this. 8x plus 100 is equals to this 9 will get multiplied here. 9 into x plus 9, it will become 9x plus 81. Right, because 9 will get multiplied to both. 9 into x, 9x plus 9 into 9, 81. Now this 9x will get here, this 8x will get subtracted here, and this 81 will come here. So 9x minus 8x becomes x, and this 100 minus 81 becomes 90. That means x is equals to 90, means initial average is a 90. But they are asking you here a new average. So what is the new average you have taken here? New average is equals to x plus 9, which is equals to 19 plus 9, which is equals to 28. So this will be your answer. By the conventional method, this is how you will solve this question. Now, okay.
And this is the question number 4. You like the explanation, okay? So, this is the question number 4 now. Let's solve this question. Yeah. So, the average weight of 19 student is a 15 kg. By the admission of a new student, the average weight is reduced to 14.8. Now, the average is reduced. So, weight of a new student. What was our formula? Weight of a new student, that means new observation, right? As I said, weight of new student weight. I will write down your new student weight, which is equals to old students, right? Number of old students into increase in average. Here it is a decreasing, so no issue. You can say decrease in average, okay? Whether it is an increase or decrease, it does not matter. Plus the new average. Okay, so what will be the new student's weight? Initially, how many students were there? 19 students, right? And how much decrease in the average? As from 15, it has become 14.8. That means average will be minus 0.2, right? 15 is 14.8 hoga. That means it will become minus 0.2. Plus, what is the new average? 14.8. Now, this 19 into 2, it will become 3.8. But it will become minus 3.8 plus 14.8. So, what will be the answer? 14.8 minus 3.8, it will become 11. So, your answer will be 11. Very good. Many students have already answered 11, 11, 11. Very good. So, now understood to everyone?
Yeah.
If they had given the new average, will that formula won't work?
In this, they have given the new average, this formula is work. Okay, Srivida, your doubt is clear with this question.
So now let's go for the next type, as this is a clear, everyone, clear to everyone. Now the next type was, this is practice questions, I will show you in the end. Let's see this first. When the members is replaced by the group,
okay, what happens? When any member, in this type, the new member was added. Here, any one member will be replaced by the new member.
okay, there will be suppose total 5 members, jo 5th member tha uska weight suppose 54 kg tha, he will get replaced, he just got a new person added whose weight is the 64. Now what is the average? This type of questions will be here, okay? So what is the formula for this? I will explain this formula for that one. Whenever this type of question, when the person is replaced, then the formula is that new observation, that means whatever the new person is added. Okay, new observation is equals to whatever the new person is added, which is equals to old observation. That means who is getting replaced? Koi to replaced ho raha, right? That old observation plus the number of observations into increase in average. That means total number of people, how many number of persons are there into increase in the average. Okay, sometimes it might be the decrease. Don't worry, you just give the negative sign there. So in multiplication, the sign of greater number rules doesn't apply. No, in the multiplication, it does not apply. It apply only in the addition and subtraction. Okay, you are confused that way. Okay, so this is the question now. You can solve by this formula. As we are in this question, only this is the formula. Because there are two unknown. So you will solve by this way only. Okay, so as you know, the average weight of 8 men increased by 1.5 kg when one of the men who weighs 65 kg is replaced by a new one. That means there was one person whose weight was a 65. Now this man has replaced by the another man, and this average is increased by the 1.5 kg within this 8 number of people. So what will be the weight of a new man? So you know that after replacing, that weight is increased by the 1.5 kg, right? That 1.5 kg will increase to the all those 8 people. That means how much weight is increasing? 1.5 into 8. Or else you can directly put here value. New members weight is equals to old one. Old one ka weight kitna tha? 65. This 65 plus whatever the number of observation. There are total 8 number of people. So this will be the 8 into how much increase? 1.8. So 65 plus 15, 8s are 120. But that will be 120, here will be point. So 65 plus 12, it becomes 77. Okay, everyone is okay with this? Answer would be 77. You just have to put the value here. There is no any another method actually. This is the best and smallest method to solve this. Okay, everyone is okay. Number of observation after the new one. As you know, here the number of person is only replacing. That means after adding new one or not one, that number of observation will remain same here. Because that person is a replaced. Matlab ek jaake uske jagah pe dusra aa raha hai. That means that is not changing. Okay? No, there is no any conventional method actually. Because there are too many, what can we say? There are too many unknown here. What is some no number of observation will be old one without adding new one? Yeah, without adding, because by adding them, it is not changing here. Because ek ja raha hai, uske jagah pe dusra aa raha hai. That means number of observations are same. Yes, that is what I am saying. Old observation and number of old observation and number of new observation will always remain the same. Okay. Now let's solve the next question of the same type. Actually, if you know this formula, you can answer this orally even. As you know that number of person, if you read the second question, now we will solve by the orally. Okay, let's try. Okay, we won't take what we'll do as next two questions are of the TEES level questions. So we will take in a fresh. Now this is the last question. So please concentrate here. Okay, for today, this is the last question. Let's see. So what is happening? The average weight of 8% increases by the 2.5 kg. When new person comes in place of a weighing 65 kg. This is the same. That means 65 kg jo ja raha hai, utna to wo definitely rahega. But what happens? Why definitely rahega? Because jo bhi new person sa raha hai, usse mera average increase ho raha hai. That means minimum 65 will definitely be there. But that person will have more weight. Then only it is possible that average is increasing. Right? And that average is increasing by what? 2.5. that average is increasing 2.5 and into number of people is equals to 8. That means that sum, whatever the sum is increasing, that increasing sum is a 2.5 into 8, which is equals to 200. That means 20, right? 25 8s are 200, but that is a point. That means 20. That means, of course, that sum should be increased by the 20. Then only possible the average will be 2.5. So initially 65 is there plus 20 is added. That means answer should be the 85. If you think the logically, then definitely you can solve these questions orally too. The formula you gave earlier was new observation is equals to number of old observation. That was for when the number of person is added. Here the number of person is replacing. This is the difference. Usme number of person ek koi add ho raha tha. Yahan pe ye person replaced ho raha hai. This is the difference. Please understand the difference also. This is the different type. Easy. Can we calculate average from this question?
And of course, you can find out the average also, increasing the average. As you don't know the exact sum, so how will you find the average number of people? And yeah, I don't think so you can find, but let's see.
But have you understood this formula at least?
How will we solve this question by this? As you know,
65, old observation, that means old person's weight,
plus the total number of people are 8 into increase in average is a 2.5, which is equals to 65, plus 25 is 8, are, it will be 20, so answer would be 85.
Easy, very good. Oops. So let me read the questions first. If anyone have question which I have missed, then please ask in the Q&A section. Yeah, in this question it says increase by 2.5. Yes. So what? In English, please. I have explained in the English again, right? I have already explained in English. Will this come in a test? The next question is of the test level. So everyone is okay with this question? Okay, this is the test level question now in front of you. So what's the time? It's a 10:35.
So let's take a screenshot and try for today. In tomorrow we will solve this question. These two questions we will solve first and then we will go for the next steps.
Okay, let's take a screenshot. How is 8 into 2.5 is equals to 20?
Because 25 into 8 is a 200. And as it is a 2.5, that means there is a 1. From right, there is a 1 digit. So from the right, I will take 1 digit. So it will become a 20. Okay. Or else, what can you do? 2.5 into 8. 8 5s are 40, carry a 4, this point is the same. 8 2s are 16 plus 4, it will become 20. 20.0 means 20.
Give both questions. Yes, I am giving both the questions. This is the question number 3 and this is the same type of the question number 3, 4. That means question 3 and 4 are the copy of each other. Only numbers are different, you can say.
So you can try and of course in the next session we will take all those questions.
Okay. Yeah. So these are the practice questions. Let's take the screenshot of the practice questions also. These are the same. Please show the third ones. Okay. I will show you all the practice questions also and third one also. This is a practice question, set number 8. Sorry, set number 6. Because this is a type 6, right? So it's like number 6. So have you taken the screenshot? Okay, you want the question number 3. Let's take the screenshot fast. TESnet 2017 question is there. This was the last type.
Not last type. 3 more types are remained.
for today's session, this was the last time. Answer key is there itself. In that question, there is answer key. Okay, this is the type number 2's questions because this was the remain. So these are also the questions. Practice set B. Yeah, this is the practice set B. Answer key is here itself. You can see. In the right corner, there is the answer key. Is this for type 5? Yeah, this is for the type number 5. There should be the practice question set 5. Okay. This is for the type number 5. Because here we are adding one member. Please understand this, okay? Type 5 was for the adding the member. Type 6 for replacing the member. This was the difference. And type number 6, you can answer orally too. Practice set 3. This is the practice set 2. Everyone is okay with practice set 2. This was the practice set 1. Everyone has taken the screenshot for practice set 1, right? I'm showing it once again. All the practice set, please take a screenshot fast. This is the for the practice question 1, that is the type number 4. Done? Yes, okay. So after this is the type number 5, that means practice questions 2, which I have just shown. So I think so you have taken this screenshot. Right, there are only 3 screenshots. Done, very good. And this is a practice question 3, that is the set number 3 screenshot. So that's all for today. I hope you have understood this all, and thank you so much. Bye bye, take care.